carbon is the soul of organic chemistry. And carbon along with hydrogen. Okay, so carbon, hydrogen and its derivatives. This is the modern definition of organic chemistry. The study of carbon and hydrogen and its derivative is nothing but organic chemistry. So the study of these compounds are done in a separate branch of chemistry, which is called organic chemistry. Right? So who is the best friend of carbon? Hydrogen. But you will see that it's not just carbon and hydrogen chemistry. You will see the carbon, hydrogen and its derivatives also. So, why is it that carbon is something which is so important? If you actually take a look at the whole world, okay? So, let's do that actually. Let's take a look, a peep into the world and see how important is this soul of chemistry, carbon. Have a look. Let's enter Earth, okay, everyone. Let's sail through. Let's enter from the space. Slowly and gradually, you're entering a ground. Look at this. You're surrounded by organic compounds, let me tell you. And if we actually focus on the hair, in fact, even the hair of a human being, what we find out, there is keratin. And if we go further into these follicles, if we go further into these hair strand, what do we find out? We find out that in the core of these organic compounds is lying a very important element, a very important atom, which is none other than carbon. Carbon is the soul of organic chemistry. But I'm sure that there is this very simple question, which is a very basic, very foundation question, that why only carbon? Why this partiality towards carbon? So this is a question that I'm sure is a very basic one, but very important one. Why are there countless organic compounds around us? What properties are responsible for these countless organic compounds around us? So let me frame it in a form of question and answer this particular question. The question is, why are there countless organic compounds around us? And I have given you options. Option A, tetravalency of carbon. Option B, catenation. Option C, tendency to form bonds with other non-metals. Option D, all of these. What do you think? What do you think? This is class 10th. Hey, this does not require a great explanation from my end. I'm sure you all can answer this. What do you think should be the right answer? Well, I'm sure that right answer is option D, that all of you will easily tell me. So let's understand, in fact, option A, B, and C in a greater depth. So the first one is tetravalency of carbon, right? So let's take a look at this first option, which is tetravalency of carbon. What do we mean by this particular property of carbon, which is tetra? Tetra means four, valency. So you know what valency is. You've just done redox. So let's see the tetravalency of carbon out here. The ability of carbon to form four bonds. Look at this. It is forming four bonds. Tetravalency. This is very important. This is very, very important. Second, catenation. Catenation is what? The self-linking property of carbon. Have a look. Carbon has a tendency to form bond with its own self, self-linking ability. Carbon-carbon bond, in fact, there's not just carbon-carbon single bond. You see carbon-carbon double bond. You see carbon-carbon triple bond. So the carbon has a great tendency to form bond with itself. Self-linking ability is called catenation. And third, the most important one, tendency to form bonds with other non-metals. So this is a misconception that just carbon and hydrogen, the chemistry of carbon and hydrogen is organic chemistry. No. Have you seen carbon-nitrogen bond? Have you seen carbon-halogen bond? Have you seen carbon-oxygen bond? Have you seen carbon-sulfur bond? I may get tired, but the ability of carbon to form bonds with other elements will not end here. In fact, carbon just not combines with non-metals. Carbon has an ability to combine with metals also, right? So organometallic chemistry is again a very important part of organic chemistry, where we study the carbon and metal bonds, okay? So that is something which is a speciality of carbon, that it has an ability, it accommodates, it makes everybody very, very comfortable with itself. Very hospitable element carbon is. So carbon is the soul of organic chemistry. And you know the best friend of carbon, which is hydrogen. But let's not restrict our knowledge to carbon and hydrogen. We know that carbon can form bonds with other elements also. So carbon, hydrogen, and its derivatives, that's what is organic chemistry all about.